Today we're going to be testing the new FileMaker input-output script steps. So here is my demo file. And now we have a different options we can do here. So we can create a file, we can write to the file, delete it, rename, or just read and input our data from that file onto FileMaker. So let's go ahead and start by making a file. So I'm typing here demo.txt, and whenever I click the create file, it's going to create a file on my desktop here. So let's try that. So you can see now over here we have a file called demo.txt, which is blank. So it's just been created. Now if we want to write to it, we click on the write to file. Now, if we come over here, we click on this, and now we can tell that there's data in here. Other things we can do is rename files, read and delete. So let's go ahead and rename this to be new demo. Click rename. And it's gonna bring up a window where you can select which file you wanna rename. In this case, we wanna rename our file that we just created. So if you go over here to our desktop, you see the file has been renamed. Now let's go ahead and read it. We wanna put in all the data into this container that we have, or it can be a text field. Let's go ahead and click read. It's going to prompt us. We want to select new demo, insert, and you see that here we have our new text from that file. Last, the delete button will delete a file that you want to select. So we want to delete this one. And now over here, it has been deleted. Now let's take a look at the code real quick. So first we have our write/create file. So here, since I have separate buttons, but I'm using the same script, I'm actually sending in a parameter, which is the action. Now, if the action is create, I set my file name to the text box that has been inputted here. Set my file name, my temp path is just a desktop. Here is the actual step, create data file. If for some reason there's an error, I send back a message to the user. And then at the very end, I exit the script. Now, if it was the write to file, we do similar things. We get the file name, we get the desktop path, and then the script set is open data file. Now, this will prompt you to save the ID. Now, you can save it to a variable or a field. In this case, I'm doing a variable called file ID. I'm error trapping down here. Sorry, this is the open data file. Yeah, down here, I'm doing the write to file. So I'm giving it the file ID that I want to write to, the test data that I want to write. And then you can specify if you want to write in UTF-16 or 8. And the append line feed, it just puts in a blank line at the end. Error trap. And then it's very important that you close the file afterwards, otherwise it will remain locked and you won't be able to work on it again until you close it. So that is the write and create. Here is the rename. So in this case, I'm doing an insert file so I get the file that the user wants to rename. I create the file path. Now the first thing I do is actually do a file get file exists. So this is also one of the new steps. And this will return whether or not the file actually exists in that path. If it doesn't, I'll let the user know. Then I open it. Down here, I actually rename it. And this is the new name that we have here. I error trap for any errors. If there is an error, I still close the file. And if it's not, I close it and exit. Read is very, very similar. Same concept. We get the file path from the user. We open the file. We have the read step and then error trap and then close the file. And delete is a little bit more simple. We just need the file path of the file we want to delete. And in this case, we don't actually have to open it. And then my startup is just checking to see if which version the user is on. But that is the new FileMaker IO script steps, which allow you to create files, write, rename, delete. But that's it, folks. Thank you.